as our implementations of nonviolent resistance and NVR began to spread, and we started getting more and more parents who came to us for all kinds of problems, we saw that the approach might be adapted, modified also for anxiety disorders. Originally, it was planned for, let's say, externalizing disorders like violence, disruptive behavior, self-risk behaviors. And at a certain point, we saw that more and more parents of kids with internalizing disorders were coming to us, and we had to do an adaptation of the method, of the approach of NVR, nonviolent resistance, to these parents and these children. The first adaptation was the model that was called SPACE. SPACE is an acronym, Supportive Parenting for Anxious Child Emotions. Okay, that's the SPACE, but we also use the word space in the sense that the parents have to get back their space, which is very much impinged upon by the child, and the parents feel the need to accommodate to the child's expectations and demands all the time, losing their space. So in space, they learn to recover their own boundaries, their own life, their marital life, their place in the family, their social life, and to positively resist the demands, the pressure exercised by the child, that they may accommodate to his or her anxiety. That's what we did in space. So we wrote the manual, which was published by Wiley, Eli Leibovich, and Chaim Omer, 2013, Parent Training for Childhood and Adolescent Anxiety, a Guide for Caregivers, Wiley, as I said. And the first, it was a field study, the control studies came afterwards. Okay, the first field study that Eli Leibovich conducted at Yale, okay, Leibovich, Omer, Hermes, and Cahill, 2014, Parent Training for Childhood Anxiety Disorders, the SPACE program, Cognitive and Behavioral Practice, 21, pages 456-469. Okay, this was the first study about anxiety disorders, field study yet, not controlled yet. What Eli Leibovich did is that he collected a group, okay, of 10 families, parents, whose children absolutely refused any kind of therapy for their anxiety disorder, either psychological or medical, anything, to complete, okay, therapy refusers. Probably the percentage of refusal in children with anxiety disorders is about 50%. So this constitutes a real problem. What do you do when the child is not willing to come to therapy? So this could be a solution, because our training, our manual is completely parent-based, 10 sessions, completely parent-based, in which the parents learn how to resist, okay, the pressures of the child for them to accommodate, to diminish their level of accommodation. Parental accommodation is the chief predictor of symptoms, chronicity, and low functioning in children. Okay, so this was the first time that particularly accommodation was targeted with a view to reducing anxiety and symptoms, and also parental helplessness, parental stress. Okay. So these parents underwent 10 sessions of treatment, and we checked both their accommodation. We had a checklist on parental accommodation, which had been validated in the literature, their level of stress, and also the child's anxiety and functioning level. What we found was very, very clear improvements in all of those counts, both in parents, okay, helplessness and accommodation, and in the child's anxiety and functioning level, which went up. Okay, this was very, very clear. It was maintained at the follow-up. In the study, it was not a long follow-up, about 2 month follow-up later, okay? We did better studies, more controlled studies, but this was a pioneering study. And one of the important, maybe okay, very important results is what happened with the children's readiness to come to therapy. It turned out that 7 out of these 10 children were willing, after the parents went through their course of therapy, now they were willing to undergo CBT for their anxiety disorders, which were not willing to do before. And we asked them, how come they were now ready when they weren't ready to do before? And they gave two kinds of answers, which are very illuminating. The first answer was, well, beforehand, we didn't think we could survive the anxiety. Now we found out that we can survive. So if I can survive the anxiety, right, don't die or get crazy, so at least that I suffer less. And they were willing to go and have CBT for that. The second explanation that they gave was, well, I wasn't willing to go to therapy because I was afraid that if I went to therapy, my parents would stop doing all of those services of accommodation, okay, which protected it from anxiety. But now they stopped doing those services, so I don't have anything to lose anymore. So they were willing to go into therapy. So I would find that that is a very interesting result. Another interesting result is that we had zero dropout. Okay, parents, all the parents who began the study concluded the study. And as we shall see, this is quite a stable characteristic of all the projects that we have that are based on nonviolent resistance. Very, very low parental dropout, the lowest in the literature. Thank you.